Hello friends, this is Yogesh Maromkar. In this video we are going to see Niobe's theorem. So we are going to use a simple example to explain how Niobe's theorem works. Basically, Niobe's theorem is a supervised it comes under supervised learning type of method. So we will see what it is all about. Niobe's theorem is basically based on Bayes equation. So the equation which you are able to see here, that is probability of A given B is equal to probability of B given A into probability of A divided by probability of B. So this particular equation is called as Bayes equation. So Niobe's theorem is basically based on this particular equation. Some people may read it like this: probability A after B is equal to probability B after A into probability of A divided by probability of B. This is nothing but the ratio of two probabilities, that is A and B. You may read it like this also: probability A such that B is true is equal to probability B such that A is true into ratio of probabilities of A and B. So let us start with a simple example to understand the working of Niobe's theorem. So we will discuss a famous example. You might have already seen this example. So we will discuss this particular example. Now, this is a data given to us, which is talking about the different attributes like day, whether it is 1, 2, 3, 4. So till 14 days of data is given to us. Next attribute is outlook, whether it is sunny or the overcast outlook or there is a rain. Next attribute is talking about temperature, whether it is hot or cool or mild. Then humidity, whether it is high, normal. Wind, weak or strong. And whether to go for playing cricket or not, either yes or no. So this table is giving us 14 days of information. For example, on first day, the outlook was sunny, temperature was hot, humidity was high, wind was weak. So whether to go the did we play the cricket? Did we play cricket? Yes or no? No. Similarly, on second day, outlook was sunny, temperature hot, humidity high, wind was strong. Play cricket? No. For example, on eighth day, outlook was sunny, temperature mild, humidity was high, wind weak. Whether to play cricket? No. So this is the data for total 14 days. Now, you have been asked a question. For example, to understand Niobe's theorem, we will see, we will try to solve one question which is based on this particular data for 14 days. Okay. So, this is the question. Now, they are saying, given this particular data for 14 days, now you find the probability to play cricket on 15th day, where conditions are given like this. That is, temperature is cool, humidity high, wind strong, outlook is sunny. That means, given this data for 14 days, we need to find out whether to play cricket on 15th day or not. Given that temperature is cool, humidity is high, wind is strong, and outlook is sunny. That means we can put it like this. I want to find out this one. We have been asked this thing. On 15th day, what is the value of outlook? They are saying that, so I will highlight it like this. On 15th day, they are saying that if outlook is sunny, temperature is cool, humidity is high, and wind is strong. So in this question, they are asking us whether to play cricket on 15th day or not, given these conditions. So we are going to predict this thing, or we are going to find out this particular thing based on this particular data by using Niobe's theorem. So how to do that we will see. So the first step to solve this particular question based on this data, what we need to do is we need to expand the data, or we need to look at the data in different way. So for that, what we will do, we will do expansion step. How to do that expansion step? So what I will do is, I will consider this particular column, for example, and I will count how many records are given. So 14 days of record is given to us, right? 14 days. So total number of records or total number of rows in that table, how many rows? So total number of rows are 14. Okay. Now if I talk about this particular column, whether to go for playing cricket or not, if I talk about this particular column, this is the data for 14 days. Okay. So what I will do is, I will divide that particular column or attribute into two types. Why I am dividing it into two types? Because how many varieties of values are given in this particular column? Only two, either yes or no. So I will divide it like this. Yes and no. So what I will do is, I will count how many are yes and how many are no. So if you count how many are yes, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So total 9 yes are there. So I will just write it down here, 9. And remaining will be no, that is 5, because it is total 14. So this is very, very important for us. Total yes are 9 and total no are 5. So if I want to find out the probability of yes, so what I will do is, I will write it down like this. Probability of yes is equal to, we know that if you want to find out the probability, what we do? Expected outcome divided by total number of outcomes. So that is number of probability of E is equal to number of E divided by number of S. That we already know how to find out the probability. It is from the definition of probability. So if I want to find out the probability of yes, what I will do is, probability of yes is equal to number of yes is what? 9. And total number of records is what? 14. So this is probability of yes. Similarly, what will be the probability of no? Number of no divided by total number of records, that is 14. So 5 by 14 is the probability of no. Now out of this, what is important for us? These two values are very, very important for us, because we are going to need these values in the latter steps to get our answer. So what you will have to do is, you will have to remember these values. Total number of yes are what? 9. Total number of no? 5. We are also going to need these things also, but at the last step only. But in between, we are always going to need these values. Total number of yes? 9. Total number of no? 5. That's why I marked it as star. Okay. Now after this step, now we will actually start with the expansion step. So what is expansion step? So what I will do is, I will move from right to left. Now I have talked about this particular column. This is what we want to predict, whether to play cricket or no, that is yes or no. I will move from this direction to this direction, that is from right to left. Okay. Now talking about this particular attribute, that is wind, we will expand it so that we will get a clear idea about that particular attribute or column. So here what we will do is, we will expand it like this. So you can say that it's the expansion step. So if you talk about this particular attribute, wind, how many number of records are there? Obviously total number of records are 14. So there are 14 number of records given, right? Because 14 days of data is given to us, and we are asked to find out or predict for the 15th day, right? Now this 14 days of data for wind attribute, how many different varieties of values are there? So there is a variety weak, strong. Is there any other value other than weak or strong? No. So we will divide it like this. Wind is divided like this. Weak and strong. Now what we will do is, we will count how many weak and how many weak values are there, and how many strong values are there. How many number of times weak is coming and how many number of times strong is coming. So if I count weak, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I will count it once again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So total number of values or weak is coming total 8 times. So I will write down 8. And obviously, if it is coming for 8 times, total are 14. So strong will come for 6 times. So this is what we have got, right? After this, how to do the further expansion? Now, what we need to do is, we need to check how many times this week, for this week there is yes, and how many times for this week there is no. It means I can divide this week, 8 times of week, like this, into yes and no. Similarly for strong also, you can divide it like this, yes, no. What we will have to check is, we will have to check these two columns now. So how many times there is week and there is yes. So if we check week yes, so this is the first time you are getting week yes, second time you are getting week yes, third time you are getting week yes, right? Then 4 week yes, 5 week yes, and 6 times you are getting week yes. So what I can do is, you can write, so for week how many times you are getting yes, so you are getting yes as 6 times, so remaining is what, no, that means 2 times. So week no 1 time, and there will be one more time, week no, this week no, right? So 6-2. Similarly go for strong. So if you count how many times there is yes for strong, if you want to count it, we will count. So strong yes. So this is the first time you are getting strong yes, right? Then strong yes. This is the second time you are getting strong yes. Third time strong yes. Okay, that means we are getting 3 times yes for strong, and remaining is what? So total number of times strong, how many number of times strong is coming? 6. Out of that, yes are 3. So remaining 3 will be no. So this is how you can expand wind attribute, right? Now after this one bit, what we need to do is, we need to find out the probabilities. So how to find out the probability? So you can write down, for week, yes, what is the probability? So we will write it down like this. Week, after that yes is coming, so find out the probability for this. So probability week, given that yes is true, so you can calculate it like this. How many number of times yes is coming for week? So it is 6 number of times. And what is the total number of week? 8. So it is 6/8. That means that is 3/4, right? Similarly, find out the probability for week no, right? So how many number of times no is coming for week? 2 number of times. And what is the total number for, sorry, we need to calculate it like this. Actually I have made a mistake. I want to calculate this probability, right? Probability of week given that yes is true. It means it should be calculated like this. How many number of times week yes is coming? 6 times. And how many number of times, what is the total number of times yes is coming? So yes is coming for 9 number of times. We already calculated the value of yes and no. And at that time only I told you we are going to need these values. Actually by mistake I had taken it as 8, this value, it should not be this one, it should be total number of yes, because we are calculating the probability for weak yes. So total number of yes we need to consider for that. So it is actually 6/9. Okay, and how many number of times weak no will be coming? So you check, how many number of times weak no? 2. And what will be the probability for weak no? So total number of no are what? 5. So it should be 2/5, right? So there is no need to confuse. Actually it is very easy. I will do it for this one. If I want to find out this one, probability of strong yes, so probability of strong yes is equal to total number of yes, strong yes 3, and total number of yes are what? 9. So it is 3/9, like this. Similarly, probability of strong no is equal to total number of strong no 3, and total number of no we already found out at the start, that is 5. So it should be 5, right? So this is what we got. These values are important for us. These values are we are going to use at the last to get the answer. Okay, so this is the expansion for wind attribute. Okay, so ultimately, so after doing all this, what we will get is, I have written it systematically. So I have written it on this table. I have just shown you how to do it. So what we have done, total 14 records divided into 9 and 5, that is yes and no, probability of yes, probability of no. Expansion, we have done it like this. So we have done the expansion of wind. So this is what we got. So we are moving from right to left. So we have done the expansion for wind. So this is what we got, okay, and these are the values of probabilities, right? So we are done with wind. Now we will move for humidity. We will do it for humidity. So if we try to do it for humidity, you can find out how many different varieties of values are there, high and normal. That means two varieties of values are there. So whatever we have done for wind, same thing we are going to do for humidity also. So if we do like that, this is what we will get for humidity. 14 number of records, high and normal, these are the two varieties of values. 7 times high is coming, 7 times normal is coming. You can even count it. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So 7 number of times high is coming. So we have already used the same steps whatever we have used for the first column, that is wind. So this is what we got for humidity. These are the probability values we have calculated. Okay, now after wind and humidity, next we will move to the next attribute, that is temperature. Now if we see different varieties of values from temperature, they are hot, mild and cool. So difference between the previous two attributes and this attribute is that here there are three different varieties of values. Earlier we were getting only two. So again the same thing, we need to follow the same steps for temperature also. So just divide it into 3 instead of 2. So for temperature, 14 number of records. So 14, total 14 records are given. Out of that, how many different varieties are values? Hot, mild and cool. How many hot? 4. How many mild? 6. How many cool? 4. So for hot, how many yes? 2. For hot, how many no? 2. So from where I have found out this? From the table only. For hot, count no. For hot, count yes. Like this only. So by doing the same step actually, I found out this particular table. Then find out the probability. Hot yes, hot no. So this 9, why there is 9? Because total number of yes are 9. You already found it out in the first step. Similarly, probability mild yes, 4 by 9. Probability mild no, 2 by, actually this should be 5 because total number of no are 5. So this should be 5. It's a correction actually. Because total number of no are 5. 5, 5, 5. It should be 5. That was wrong. It should be 5 only. Okay. So this is what we got for temperature attribute. Now after temperature attribute, the next attribute is what? It is outlook. So for outlook also we have three varieties of values. That is sunny, overcast and rain. So if we do same step for outlook, we will get an expansion like this. Okay, so sunny, overcast, rain. Again divide it into yes and no, and these are the probabilities. So what we have done ultimately, we have expanded wind column, humidity column, temperature column and outlook column, and we have found probability values like this. Okay, so what I have done after these, I have written all those probability values on one page so that it will be easy for us to do the further calculations. So these are the values we got. So we have written the values for probability values for temperature. Probability values for temperature we have written. Then humidity, then outlook and then wind. So all these columns. Temperature, humidity, wind and outlook. So I have written all those values which we have calculated on one page. So that it will be easy for us to do further calculations. Okay. So we are going to use these values in the next calculation. Now what will be the last step? See, what is our aim? We want to find out the answer whether to go for playing cricket on 15th day or not, given these conditions. Now as we have given these conditions, our last step will be what we will do is we will use one factor, that is x. So let us say there is a factor as x, and in that factor x we will put the given conditions, that is sunny, cool, high and strong. Sunny, cool, high, strong. So let us say we are putting those values in a factor called as yes. Now I want to calculate the probability for yes given these conditions. So what I will do is I will use this formula. Probability x for yes is equal to probability of yes into probability sunny yes, probability cool yes, probability high yes and probability strong yes. So all these values we are already having with us as we have calculated it and we have written it on one page. So if we use this formula. It's very easy formula. If I want to find out probability of x, that means probability of these for yes. So what we need to do is just write down the probability of yes, then find out sunny yes, cool yes, high yes, strong yes. So these values you will get from this. So probability of yes, so we have at the start only we have calculated the probability of yes. So this is the first step. So probability of yes is 9/14 and probability of no 5/14. So what we need to do is we need to write down the value for this probability of yes. So it is 9/14, okay, into this is the multiplication sign, probability of sunny yes. So from where you will get the value of probability of sunny yes, we have written it here. So probability of sunny yes is what, 1/9. So here you can see, and you know how we have calculated it, right, by expansion step. So it's 1/9. Then probability of cool yes, so probability of cool yes, that is temperature, cool yes is what, 3/9. So you write down 3/9 multiplied by what is next, probability of high yes. So probability of high yes, 3/9, you just write down 3/9 multiplied by probability of strong yes. So probability of strong yes, again 3/9, you just write down 3/9. So if you do the calculations, we got this particular value for yes, right, 0.0053. So I already done the calculations, you can use calculator and you can check these values, so you will get 0.0053. similarly, you will have to do it for no also. So probability x no is equal to probability no into probability sunny no, cool no, high no, strong, and we have already found out these values. So what is the value of probability of no? So this value you will get from the first step, probability of no is equal to 5/14, right? So just write down this value, probability of no, this value, it is 5/14, right? Next, probability sunny no, so probability of sunny no is 4/5, so you write in 4/5. Next, so this is done. Probability cool no, so probability cool no is 1/5, so you write it down 1/5. Then next is probability high no, probability of high no is 4/5, so you write down 4/5, right? And the next one is probability strong, so probability of strong no is 3/5. So 3/5. So if you do the calculations, you will get this value 0.00206. So our last step will be, what we need to do is to find out the answer. Our aim was to find out the answer for this question. If given on 15th day, if given these conditions, that is outlook is sunny, temperature cool, humidity is high, wind is strong, whether to play cricket or not. So to find out this answer, what we need to do is we just need to compare the values of yes and no. So for x we know sunny, cool, high, strong. So for yes we got 0.0053 and for no 0.0206. so out of these two values, the greater value is 0.0206. that means no is having more impact as compared to yes. That means our answer should be no. So what we should write down on 15th day is, we should not go for playing cricket on 15th day, given outlook is sunny, temperature is cool, humidity is high, and wind is strong. So the answer should be no. Why? Because value of no which we got is greater as compared to value of yes, that is 0.0206 is greater as compared to 0.0053. that's why this answer should be no as compared to Neo Bayes theorem. So this is a simple example of a Neo Bayes theorem. So this is how you can proceed with the help of Neo Bayes theorem. So you can try the same example, or you can try different example also by following the same steps, okay? So that's it for Neo Bayes theorem. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you very much, friends. Thanks a lot.